The Presidential Task Force, PTF, on COVID-19 has lamented over the failure of many Nigerians to adhere strictly to advisories regarding the lockdown relaxation. During its briefing on Monday, the PTF, through its chairman, Boss Mustapha, stated that close monitoring of activities since the morning reveals that the level of compliance is unsatisfactory, especially with regards to social distancing and the use of masks. Boss Mustapha, in his opening remarks, specifically noted that the crowds at the banks pose great risk. While maintaining that there is a high level of violation of the guidelines, the PTF chairman revealed that interstate travel ban has not also been complied with, stressing that the evacuation of Almajirays from different states does not respect the guidelines nor follow the rule of the ban. Joining us live is Amadin Uyi in Abuja. Good morning to you, Amadin, and thank you for joining us.
Good morning, Benny.
You were at the nuke and cranny of Lagos, Abuja, I beg your pardon, earlier today. What is the general feeling and reactions towards relaxing the lockdown?
Now, let me first of all start from the position of the PTF. The Presidential Task Force, they've done tremendously well in the last 5 weeks. But the question we should be asking is whether their effort has been good enough. I'll tell you in terms of ensuring that social distances is adhered to, in terms of ensuring that Nigerians accept the full grasp of the pandemic on our hands, their efforts have not been good enough. Because one is tempted to ask the question whether it is only in the city centers that the task force is committed or is willing to ensure that these issues of social distancing, the issues of ensuring that Nigerians use face masks and Nigerians use hand sanitizers is obeyed. So if the PTF has just come after almost 5 weeks to realize that Nigerians are not adhering to social distancing, are not using their face masks, are not using their hand gloves, are not using keeping proper hygiene practices, then it is only unfortunate. Now the PTF has woken up from his slumber and realized that Nigerians are not doing these things. And I've said that going forward, Nigerians should do so or they will extend the lockdown. But let them also consider the economic implications of extending the lockdown. I think the PTF has the mandate of President Muhammadu Buhari. They have the security agencies at their beck and call. They need to be more proactive. They need to put their foot on the ground and assert their authority. Because in satellite communities, in the suburbs, these places where more Nigerians reside, these rules are not being adhered to. And the fear is that when the pandemic reaches a community spread, they were in deep trouble.
Let's take a look at transportation yesterday in Abuja. Would you say the bus operators complied with the guidelines issued as regard number of passengers in the bus?
From what we saw on ground, there was nothing like adherence to social distancing by transport operators. It was business as usual, especially in the satellite communities. And it did not start from yesterday. It started since the lockdown has been in place. It's only the city center you see security operators ensuring that there is no movement. But in almost all satellite communities where you have more than 80% of Nigerians residing, nobody is thinking about social distancing or adhering to any rule that will curb the spread of the COVID-19 pandemic.
Are there security operatives to enforce or check compliance with the stipulated guidelines?
The only thing we have seen security operatives do in the last 2 or 3 weeks is mount roadblocks. And roadblocks cause more pain. When you mount roadblocks, you cause a severe traffic gridlock. Then where is social distancing? You put transporters and you put commuters on the edge. And everybody just wants to get home. Like yesterday night when we were returning after work, roadblocks were everywhere, severe traffic gridlock, no social distancing. But the security operators were only interested in ensuring that there is a curfew and they want to keep to the tenets of the curfew. But I think one misplaced idea is that any effort by security operators, any effort by the PTF, any effort, it should be geared towards one aim. And what is that aim? Reducing the spread of the pandemic.
Plus TV Africa's Abuja Bureau Chief Amadin Uyi, thank you very much for joining us and for your contribution.
Thank you, Benny.